In this video, I'm going to be sharing my top tips for how to build confidence in business. The first tip I'd like to give you is to manage your state. Confidence is often reflected in how we show up, so that comes in two ways. One is your posture and where you're gazing. And so to make a positive impact on how confident you're feeling is often related to how you're holding your head and where your gaze is directed. And so if you're looking downward or straight ahead, you may not be showing up as confident as you'd like to. So my suggestion is what I call a 2 millimeter shift, which is a slight lift of your eyes and your head, which gives you a sense of confidence, and it's an instantaneous physiological change that happens when you do that. My next tip in building confidence is fear setting. The process of fear setting is when we have big goals, which I know you all do, and you've written out your goals, is to then go through the process of literally documenting what are the fears that possibly are holding us back and diminishing our confidence and going after them. So getting out a sheet of paper and literally writing down what is the worst case scenario that could possibly happen. What are the failures that may impact you by going after this particular goal? And getting all of that negative talk out of your head and onto a piece of paper. Then setting that aside and really going through a second part of the exercise, which would be identifying how your life will look if you never even approach or start to go after the goal at all, and what type of impact that has in your life. So the action here is to then evaluate both of those lists and really lean into whether your fears are holding you back or if they're realistic, and go down either path very confidently. My next tip for building confidence is done is better than perfect. Getting your product or service out there and getting it launched and not holding back so that it's, you know, not perfectly gift wrapped and bow tied, I think is a really important thing. The sooner you can launch with your product, you're getting customer feedback, you're getting market feedback, you'll make your product better, and in the end will save you a ton of time, energy, and money in doing rework. I can think of a number of clients, but specifically very common in the software and app development company, that developers tend to over design and develop before they know that it will suit the customer's needs. So called the MVP, or launch with what you can and then build it as you're flying it. My next confidence building tip is to develop yourself. I find that many of my clients are very good in their particular technical area of expertise. And in developing yourself, we really try to identify where is that your organization may be struggling or your career may be falling flat, and looking for resources to be able to build confidence and new skills for yourself. So whether that's leadership or recruiting and retention or marketing and sales, finding a resource, a conference, a seminar or workshop to give you new ideas and ways to think about that will shift and lift your confidence. Another element is that sometimes our confidence builds by actually doing non-work related things. So finding time to have fun in your life and scheduling that part of your calendar, and not just be all work, but figure out things that will fill your cup and give you rest and recoup and come back more in charge and confident in your daily work.